Well, hi there. My name's Gummy Roach. Thanks for joining me once again in my basement TV studio. Today, we're going to be talking about old school technology, old school video editing. Now, when people first started getting home camcorders and VCRs, they'd go out, they'd record a bunch of vacation videos, and if they wanted to edit, they would basically borrow their neighbor's VCR, or they'd copy from their camcorder over to their main VCR, and they'd put the main VCR in the record, and then they'd pause it, queue up their camcorder footage to what they wanted to save, and then copy that over to the main VCR. And kind of a cumbersome process, but it was effective. But what if you wanted to put titles or maybe some fancy graphics on your videos? With just standard VCRs, it's kind of hard to do. Most VCRs didn't have anything fancy built into them. Well, along came a company called Videonics, and they created this gadget right here. Let me switch over here. I love this little thingy on my desk. I can switch cameras. Okay, so this right here, what is this gadget? You might have seen these advertised on eBay if you like old analog video equipment. You look at that and you go, what in the world is that? Just a gray box with a couple of fancy lights on the front of it. This is made by Videonics. They used to make some pretty cool stuff when they were popular. They made video switchers for home video enthusiasts, and they also made some pretty cool character generators. Now, I haven't heard much about Videonics in years. I don't know if they're still around or if somebody bought them out. But anyway, this came out in, late 80s. Or early 90s. This is the Videonics Video Control Unit. It was packaged as DirectED Plus. Now, DirectED Plus is actually a program that runs on this little box that allows you to hook VCRs up to it and automate the process a little bit and edit your videos. So I'm going to talk about this unit because I searched YouTube and I could not find anything on YouTube that talks about this, really. How does it work? What does it do? So I'm going to take the time to demonstrate what this thing does. We're going to set it up. How do you program it? How do you edit on this gadget? And show you what I used to do back in the early 90s when I would edit my home videos. I don't know if I'm going to edit a complete video with this because that's a little lengthy, but I just kind of want to give you the basic steps on this. If you've ever thought about purchasing one of these on eBay and play around with it, is it worth purchasing? What does it do? So I'll let you be the judge of that. At least I'll try. But let's talk about this unit. On the outside of the unit, on the front, it's just a gray box. You've got need something I can point with. You've got it ain't polite point. Okay, you've got three lights on here. You've got the attention light. And what this does is if the Videonics, if it needs your attention, for example, if you're copying, if you're editing videos and you've got more than one source tape, this will start flashing when it is time to change your tape out, or if you need to hit the rewind or play button on your playback machine, this will come up. Or if there's an error, a computer glitch or an error, this will start flashing. Power. That everybody knows what this is. This just tells you the unit has power. Okay, the power light. All right, down below here you've got the VCR light. This will come on when the control unit is trying to talk to your VCR. If it's trying to perform any functions, this light will come on. Now, there are no controls on the front of this. There's no on-off switch. There's no drop-down door on front. It's just a box with some pretty lights on the front. The back of the unit, I'm not really going to pull this thing out and show you and risk yanking some wires there, but I'll just tell you about the back of the unit. It's just a row of standard RCA female input jacks. You've got stereo left and right in, stereo left and right out for your main VCR. You also have stereo left and right in for your playback VCR. And we've got video inputs. You also have what looks like a little tiny headphone jack on the back of it, which goes out to the controller. And that's really all it is, okay? Now, if you see one of these boxes advertised on eBay, and this is all that they're advertising, stay away from it because by itself, it does nothing. You have to be able to program this box, and you need some accessories for it to do you any good. So make sure it comes with the remote control unit. This remote control is proprietary. It's got the whole alphabet here and a bunch of numbers. You can't just use any old run-of-the-mill control with it. You need the proprietary Videonics remote control. So if you see one of these things advertised and you don't see the remote control with it, pass it up because it will be useless without it. You need the remote control, okay? Additionally, you need, for it to be able to control your VCRs, you need an infrared controller. And what this is just an infrared diode, little light bulb here on the end, which is pretty much the same thing you'd find at the end of your VCR remote control. It's just a remote control. It's got a little cord, and the end of the cord is just a little 1/8 inch mini plug, which will plug into the control jack on the back of the Videonics unit up here. If it didn't come with one of these, you can find these occasionally by themselves in junk bins. I think sometimes you can special order these, but it's just a standard infrared controller on a cord with a 1/8 inch phone jack. All right, this unit, this wand would go in front of your VCR. I have a spare one, and it's down here already in front of the VCR, and all it does is it just acts as a remote control to put your machine in record, playback, fast forward, rewind, pause, all that. So it takes the place basically of your handheld remote. That's all that does. And my autofocus on my camera behind me is going crazy. But we'll get through this. Okay, so you need this. You need a control wand, infrared control wand. You need the main unit. And to be able to program this thing, you cannot connect this to a computer. So how do you program it? Well, I don't know how many of you remember the old computers of yesterday, like the Texas Instruments 99-4A or the TRS-80 and the Commodore 64. Those machines, if you wanted to save your data, if you didn't have a floppy drive, you would save it on cassette tape. Well, because we're dealing with video, it saves it onto videotape. It doesn't save it in the form of screechy audio noises like a modem, like your typical computer tape does. What's really cool about this is it saves it in the form of video signals. And as we dig into this deeper, I'll show you what that actually looks like. It's pretty cool. I've not seen anything else like that anywhere else. But I'm rambling here. I'm good at that. I confess. What you need is the getting started tape. Okay? This contains the video data needed to program the Videonics DirectED Plus control unit up here. So if you're buying one of these on eBay, make sure you've got that. You need this tape, you need the remote control, and you need the control wand. Okay? Without those things, forget it. You just bought an expensive boat anchor. Now, how expensive? When this was brand new, believe it or not, I bought this from a sporting goods company in their camera section. I bought that for about $450. So it's a pretty pricey unit for its time. it's not worth that now, of course, because you know you've got Adobe Premiere and all those other fancy video editors that do a much better job and quicker job than this did. But we didn't have that back then in the 80s. This is what we used. So I'm going to show you how you set this DirectED Plus up. When you first power on the unit, let's see here. Yeah, we are recording. Okay, when you first power on the unit, you're going to see this little poor man's animated graphic up here. That's supposed to be a VCR, and it's asking you to put the getting started tape in the machine. So we're going to do that. My main machine, believe it or not, is the small VCR up here. I might say that this doesn't work with every single VCR out there. It works with most of them, but I do have a couple VCRs where they're too new for this unit, it does not know the remote control codes for it, which is kind of crazy. Anyhow, we're going to put this in. It's going to automatically start playing. And watch what this thing does. It's going to... There's a glitch in the tape at the beginning. But it's going to start putting a bunch of dashes on the screen. Eventually. There it goes. And it's going to fill in all these dashes. And that's how it programs. It actually reads it pretty quick. So that's kind of cool. I've never seen anything else like that anywhere as far as device programming off of videotape. But it's not audio signals it's picking up off the tape. It's actual video flashing white and black bars. It's pretty cool. So we're going to see the splash screen come up in a bit. There it is. 1989 Videonics. Videonics DirectED Plus is what this thing is running. And there is our main screen. I'm going to hit stop over here. Where is my stop button? There it is. Okay. I'm going to rewind this. All right. So we're going to set this unit up. So to do that, we're going to come down here where it says Make Movies with DirectED Plus. We're going to select, we're going to press the select button. All right. And it's asking to put movie library tape number one in the machine. We're going to hit cancel because we don't have tape one. Okay. Now it's going to come up to set up or change system. Well, we're going to set it up, so we'll hit select. All right. Normal or express mode. I really don't know the difference between the two, so we're just going to leave it on normal. And we're going to go down to setting up the play-only VCR. There's not much to set up on that. This is just a play-only VCR. You can give it a name if you want to. We won't. And it uses different formats. I mean, this will do, you can use this with Betacam, U-matic on your play. Your playback can be anything. It can be a camcorder, VHS-C, anything. All right. The mode on here, this is a stereo machine, so we'll select stereo. Okay. And then we'll go down here to done. Okay. That was simple enough. Now we're going to set up the main VCR, this one right here, this top one. And this might take a few minutes, but I'll kind of show you the basics on that. Okay. Again, we can give it a name. We can tell it what kind of machine it is. And again, as long as the control unit right here, as long as it knows, as long as it can learn the infrared codes of your machine, your main machine can be any format, VHS, beta, camcorder, whatever, as long as it will accept the infrared VCR. Not all of them will. Okay, we can go down here to, believe it or not, my main machine is a mono machine. Yeah, I'm cheap. This is just a demonstration, okay? Give me a break. All right, now we're going to go down here and learn the VCR remote control. We're going to select, okay. It's asking to put this tape, the getting started tape, back in the machine. So we're going to do that because this will start playing the remote control codes. And we need to learn how to talk to our main VCR. So we're going to put that in. I'll hit rewind. Might take a second. I'm not convinced it's at the beginning. It's just sending codes out this little wand right here. This takes a couple minutes for it to do that. We'll see the VCR stop in just a moment, and then we'll go through a series of commands like play. There goes. It stopped. Okay. Now it's playing. Now it's doing a fast forward. It's doing a search. It's queuing. Right, I'll do that for just a couple seconds. Black microphone, black shirt. Oh well, nobody's perfect, you know? Okay, so it just stopped. It's probably going to do a test of fast forward and rewind in a bit. There it goes. It is rewinding. Okay, clunk. It just stopped. Now it's telling us that it knows what the codes are, so we're going to say select. Okay. And then what we can do is we can check the control. It's a good idea to check, just in case there's any discrepancies with what it learned. So it's going to fast forward. There it goes. Stop. Okay. Now it's playing. All right. That's going to cue forward. That's going to play. It's reviewing. Playing. All right. Pause. Stop. We'll probably rewind in a bit. Yep, there it goes. Okay, rewinding. All right, step. We need to learn the playback characteristics, so we will select that. This thing kind of picky. All right, and select. And it's going to, what it's going to do is it's going to do some calculations. That this tape has some time code on it that the control unit can recognize. And it's going to learn how long it takes from stop to start to get to a certain point on a tape. How long does it take to get to that point when it fast forwards and rewinds and cues? Okay, it has learned the playback characteristics. Now we're going to learn the record characteristics, which is pretty much the same scenario. So we're going to hit select. Now it's wanting us to put a library tape, a blank tape, into the machine. All right, and this is going to be our library tape. It's going to store important data as to the remote control codes, what it has learned. It's going to store your editing decisions. All of that gets stored on this tape. So it's going to create that tape. So we're going to put that in there. I'll hit rewind. And then we will press select. Okay. See that in a minute. Okay, now it just went in the record, so it's going to do some record test. It records for a couple minutes. So if this gets too lengthy, I'll shorten it in post or try to. Okay. So now what it's going to do after it's when it's towards the end of the recording characteristics, it's going to start encoding this tape with data on it. And it's really cool how that happens. And you'll see that in just a moment. This thing will go into record mode. It puts a label at the front of the tape. And then it's going to start streaming video, flashing black and white bars. You'll see that in just a moment. It's really cool. And data stream, there it is. Isn't that weird? I've never seen anything like that with any other gadget. But this is computer data used to program the Videonics unit. That's weird. So this is like ones and zeros in the form of video signals. It's really ingenious. It's really weird. So that's going to go for just a moment. And then it's going to check and confirm that it can read back that information. It's really weird. That's one thing I think that's really ingenious with the Videonics. It's like they thought of everything. I've never seen anything like this. But that is computer language. Video signals. Pretty cool. Okay. So it's putting a trailer on the end of it. And then it's going to stop. And that's really weird, too, right there. I guess that's a cue point. I don't know. But it will put that. It'll freeze frame that for just a couple seconds. And then it's going to stop recording. It'll rewind and check it. Okay, it just stopped recording. It's going to go into rewind in a bit. Well, play, and then it will queue up. Yeah, it's backing up, looking for the confirmation that it did, in fact, record. Okay, so it has learned how to play and record on our main machine. All right, so now we're going to click on select down here at the bottom. Okay, done. Now what we're going to do is actually try to do some editing with this machine. Now one thing that's kind of cool and cumbersome is when you make edits with the DirectED Plus, it actually does, you'd make a copy of your original tape, and then it uses that copy to make all your editing decisions, because you don't want to put a lot of wear and tear on your main tape, if you can help it, and so you're doing all the fast forwarding and rewinding and cueing to make your decisions on your copy while your original stays stored safely away somewhere. And then when all your decisions are made and you're ready to make your final production, that's when you get out your original and make it do its thing. So what we do, first of all, is we copy an original tape to dub, okay? And I have an old vacation video right here, okay, that I did way back in the mid-80s, I think, when I was fresh out of high school. I'm giving myself away here. But we're going to copy some of this and do some editing with it. So we'll put this in our playback machine. All right. I'm going to hit stop because we're not ready to play yet. Okay, we're going to select copy original to dub. Okay. Dub name, well, I can call it vacation, I guess. All right. Maximum original length, you can set that for however long you like. I can put, we'll leave it at 20 for now, but it will go up to 2 hours, I think. Okay, you can view the original before copying. Nah. Okay, now we're going to say start copying. Creating new dub. Okay. And what it wants right now is another blank tape. And this is going to be library tape 2. So you go through quite a few tapes on here. Let's see, where's my eject button? Right there. This is library tape 1, this will be library tape 2. So tape 1 is your most important, I guess. It's got the control codes for the machine, but well, they're all kind of important. Okay, I'm going to rewind that to the beginning. All right, and then I'm going to select. It's making the label at the beginning of the tape. It's going to record that just a bit. pause. Yeah, it's recording. It's putting a label on it. Okay. So we've got our tape in the playback machine ready to go. And we're going to hit select. Okay. Now we're going to hit play. And as soon as it gets a picture, it's going to start recording. There we go. So, as you can tell, my white balance is way off on my dub. But it is recording nonetheless. So I'm going to record maybe 15 minutes of this. I'm not going to bore you while we're waiting for the 15 minutes to record. But we will fast forward this and I'll meet you back in just a minute after this has had a chance to record some video. Okay? All right. And it's just going to go back and confirm. Rewind, make sure everything played okay. Everything recorded okay. Saving an extra copy of your movie library data. So it'll put that on the end of it just in case we lose one of our library tapes. It will put an extra copy on here, which is pretty cool. So it's a pretty smart little gadget. All right. So now it's just rewinding to the beginning of our dub, and then we can start making some editing decisions at this point. Boy, got the hiccups. All right. Okay. So it's almost done here. Playing. You'll probably start seeing some data come down the screen here in a minute. Rotate two. There we go. Yep, there's our data. Video data. Isn't that cool? All video, computer language. So that's going to take just a moment for it to complete that. Now we're going to talk about actually editing with the Videonics DirectED Plus video editor. We've already made a dub. I've copied my original vacation tape, and so now we're going to start marking scenes on it and make a short little movie with this. So to do that, here we have our DirectED Plus main menu from Videonics. We're going to go down to Make Movie with DirectED Plus. We'll hit select. Okay, we've already copied our original to the dub. So now we're going to go down here and mark scenes on dub and place in a movie. So we need to select the dub to mark. We're going to come up here. I named that dub Vacation. All right. And we're going to create a movie title. I can call this Vacation also. V-A-Z-A-T-I-O-N. There we go. Okay. Now we're going to go down to mark scenes and place in a movie. So we'll hit select. And our tape's already in the machine. The dub tape's in the machine. It's going to start queuing up here momentarily. So what's interesting is it puts an overlay on top of the video, And with instructions, you'll see the start and end point. And you'll also see in the bottom right, it's going to tell you what the time is on the tape once it finds the beginning of the dub. Okay, so we're going to start marking this video. Here's the beginning of the video. And right now we're in, I think, Delta, Utah, on our way to Southern California for a little vacation. I've got my my buddy with me from high school. And we're taking a trip down to California just for the fun of it. Going to stay with some family friends. Well, they're family now, but back then they were just friends. And visit a couple of amusement parks and whatever. So there's my friend. Okay. All right. We're going to mark the end of that scene. Okay. And we're going to select. And we're going to start our next scene. I think we're in Las Vegas right now. We're at a gas station. And I don't think we really care about the footage here. But we are at a gas station. And there's my friend again. Old Winnebago. Okay, so we're actually in Las Vegas right now. This is 1988. And what you're going to see here, Las Vegas looks totally different compared to this video. But we're driving down the Las Vegas Strip. We'll start the scene here. And that's the old Stardust Hotel and Casino. And that's not there anymore. That's long since been torn down. But this was really impressive at night, all lit up in red and blue neon. And this sign, my goodness, the sign was huge. The Stardust Lido sign. So we're just going down the strip. I'm going to end that. Okay. Just let it keep rolling here for a bit. Okay. All right. Let's start this one. We're just going down a strip, and there's the old Frontier. That's not there anymore either. But look how huge this sign was. It was enormous. Pretty cool to see that all lit up at night. Old Frontier. Okay. Here. Stop that scene. Here's Knott's Berry Farm. Let that play. Let it queue up. Okay. Get a stable picture. Here's Knott's Berry Farm. Okay. Right there. And there's Montezuma Revenge right there. That's an old ride, but it's a lot of fun. It just goes through the loop forward and back. Yep. We'll cut right there. All right. We'll find another scene that we can use. There's a boat. Let's zoom in and then... there we go. Let's start that. Let that zoom out. I love these parachute rides. These are really cool. What I want to do on this edit, I'm going to go back a little bit. Okay. We'll do a exit. Okay, I want to zoom in and then start the edit. Okay, right here. That's the sky cabin in the sky. And you have parachute rides off of this tower. Not real parachutes, just a little ride that goes up and down. It just takes you up and then kind of a free fall down. Kind of cool. Cheap thrills. The parachutes are not there anymore. But the tower still is, and the sky cabin is still there. All right. Oh, yes, this is where, this is really cool. These aren't here either. Soapbox Derby. Okay, here they come. Let's grab that. And we'll cut right when it goes over the hill. This was a fun ride, but it's not there anymore. I don't know what they put in its place. But we went on this quite a few times. This was a lot of fun. Yep. Cut. I think I got my my out point a little. I think I missed my output point just a little bit. Okay. We'll cut right there. All right. So let's forward on a little bit. That one was kind of fun. Here's a train. Now, somewhere on this train, there was a the train robbery. So we'll catch that at the... Let's forward through here, see if we can find the train robbers. Yeah, it's a little ways in. Yeah, you can fast forward and rewind with the... you can cue forward and backwards with the Videonics remote, and you can also do that with the remote of the VCR itself. I think the VCR remote is a little bit better for that. Okay, here we go. Come on, play, you stupid thing. All right, let it run. Let's start the start point here. Here we're on the Knott's Berry Farm Calico Ghost Town train. And in just a bit, we should see the train being held up by a bunch of train robbers. Yep, there he is. And you'll see a little surprise coming up here in a minute. This guy right there. We'll cut right there. All right. Fast forward through here. That's a fun amusement park. If you have the means when you go to California, if you want to save some money instead of going to Disneyland, go to Knott's. It's a lot of fun. It's smaller than Disneyland, doesn't cost near as much, but lots of fun. So the next thing, we are at the beach. And I'm sitting in the back seat of my stepbrother's car. He wasn't my stepbrother at the time. He is now. Look at that lush hair. Oh, man. Okay. So, there we go. Zooming up on the beach. Okay. Finish that. And people playing volleyball. There's another scene here coming up that I want to get. All right. Right there. Zooming in right there. I love to zoom. I think I love it too much. Here's some hunk showing off. Everybody was young and beautiful back in those days. What happened, you know? Okay. So now, let's see. I'm driving down. Select. Here we go. Gorgeous beach babe. I have no idea who she was. She probably had no idea I was videotaping at the time. Shame on me. Nice product placement, huh? But, yeah, what's a beach without a gorgeous beach babe? Okay. We need to back this up a little bit. We need to cut this. Right there. And now, just hanging out with the family a little bit. They're family now, but at the time they were friends. It's kind of a long story. But, anyway. My stepbrother, Dallin. Here's my stepdad. There's my, friend from high school, and we had the most gross-looking homemade pizza you ever saw. It was actually pretty good. It was delicious, but kind of disgusting to look at. There you go, pizza. Mmm. And there's me in my stupid booty shorts. I was adorable back then. I didn't think so at the time, but there's Dallin, and I don't know what kind of dog that is, what kind of dog breed that is, but really cute. All right. There I am again in stupid booty shorts. shorts. But it was the 80s. That was a thing back in the day. So now Mabel's, that her name's Mabel. She's doing a little presentation for my mom to make my mom jealous. She and my mom were best friends, almost like sisters. So she's just doing a little, trying to make my mom jealous, I guess. I just loved her. I just adored her. She's not around anymore, but she was just a lot of fun. So we're going to tell it that we're done marking our scenes. Okay. Next thing we can do is we can hit select and list the scenes in the movie. And you can see we've got quite a few. You can actually rename these scenes if you really wanted to, so that you know what's what. All right. Anyhow, we're going to go back to the main menu. Okay. Now, if you want, you can view the movie before you actually put it in production. It'll flash at the start and stop points of the movie. We don't need to do that. But we'll go to done. Okay. Now, what we can do is add some titles and graphics and effects and snazz it up a bit. And I've had some problems getting the some of the graphics to superimpose, but we will give it a shot. Okay, so there's our movie, our scene. Let's do an opening scene here. Let's go back to scene number one. Okay, whoops. Come on. Let's go. Scene one, okay. And we're going to put a graphic at the beginning of this. And what you can do with these graphics, it's a little bit lame by today's standard, but you can, instead of a solid background, we are going to select Change Display. And I'm going to select On the Road, little graphic. But on the back where it says choose background color, you can choose, okay, here's our palette of colors. You can choose any of these as your background, but if we select video, it will superimpose the graphic over the top of the video, which is kind of cool. That's something you can't just do with a VCR. With most VCRs, you can't do that, but with the Videonics DirectED Plus, you can. Okay, so title color. Let's bring up our palette again. I'm going to go with this color here. Now we can create our title. And I'll just come down here. And I will put my vacation. All right. Okay. So there's that. And we can view the title and graphic. It's painting the title and graphic. So there's that. That looks nice. Now in the blue area, it will actually superimpose the moving video. It'll replace that blue with the moving video. Okay. So we'll do select. All right, and we can say, we'll say done. Okay, now we can view the scene with the title and graphics, and we should see what this actually is going to look like in the final production. And there it is. So you can see that it has superimposed the graphic over the video. So that's kind of cool. So you could do several different types of graphics with it. It will also do fades and wipes. However, you can't fade from one moving video to another moving video. You can only do that from a solid background color or a graphic to moving video. So can't have both. It does not have a time-based corrector built into the unit. All right. Anyway, you get the idea of how this is supposed to work. But the editing process with the DirectED Plus, if you've got a large production, this can take hours for it to do its thing, to edit and compose the final production, especially if you don't have the production assistant, this thing right here, then every time if your scenes are out of sequence, then when it needs your attention, this light will come on, the attention light will come on, and it will sit there and wait indefinitely for you to see that it needs your attention. So you would stop your playback machine, rewind it to the beginning, yes, the beginning of the tape, let it play, and then it will resume. It does not, the source VCR, it does not queue up. Even if with the production assistant, it does not queue up. All the production assistant does is rewind your source tape to the beginning. You have to start from the beginning of your source tape and let it play through until it finds a scene. So it's kind of a pain. It takes forever and a day or 5 days, however complex you want to make it, for this to complete your project. But it was pretty handy in the day, pretty sophisticated. I spent a lot of hours with this thing and made a few productions here and there. I didn't use it as much as I thought I was going to, but I did use it. I've done a few wedding videos with it back in the 80s, but I can tell you from experience, thank goodness for home computers, PCs, Macs, whatever, because the editing software out there now just blows this away. I mean, this is pretty much junk, or pretty close to junk, compared to what is out there now. I mean, now you can edit videos almost instantaneously and have them ready, where this would take hours and hours and hours. But I wanted to show you this anyway, because nobody else has done a video about it that I know of. And also, in particular, I wanted to show you how unique that was when it saved video data, you know, the streaming flashing bars. That is so cool. I've not seen that on any other equipment. So I hope you enjoyed this. All right. Once again, you know, there's the thumbs up and there's the like button on there. I don't really care what you do on that. I'm not going to beg you to click it and like it, whatever. You just do whatever you want, okay? I do these videos for fun. So far, I have not made any money off of any of my videos. Whether that will change in the future or not, I don't know. I think my next video, I'll probably do it with my digital cameras, and we'll see a significant improvement of picture quality, probably. Anyway, thank you for joining. I hope this was informative and entertaining. This is Gummy Roach. See you next time.